everyone, welcome to AUP Weekly News. I'm Ariel Delzer. This week's broadcast will focus on the Jane Goodall Foundation, the AUP Roots and Shoots Club, and other great clubs at AUP. But first, let's take a look at the next 2 weeks' events. Final exams are next week, starting Monday, May 12th, and ending Friday, May 16th. On Wednesday, May 14th, is the SGA Senate meeting. It is open to all students. Meet at the Grand Salon at 12 noon. Contact sgaaup.edu for more information. On Thursday, May 15th to Saturday, May 17th will be the Conference of the International Association of Literary Journalism Studies, or IALJS. The conference is hosted by AUP's Departments of English and Comparative Literature, as well as Global Communications. It will feature over 80 international scholars representing a variety of fields. Workshops will cover the fields represented. For more information, contact Professor William Dow of the Comparative Literature and English Department. Also on Thursday, May 15th is a night with Jane Goodall. AUP is collaborating with the American Church in Paris, and the event is organized by the Roots and Shoots group at AUP, as well as the SGA. Tickets can be purchased online for €20 each. Contact student_leadership@aup.edu for more information. On Monday, May 19th, degree candidate grades are due.
This is Jessica Benny, and I'll be your host this week for A Minute with Jess. Here I have two university professors, Professor Berg and Professor Piani, who are teaching here at the American University of Paris. And this week's broadcast is on environmentalism and what we can do to help the environment.
And the biggest thing in climate change, of course, is reducing your carbon footprint. And the simplest things you can do to reduce your carbon footprint is, you know, turn off a light when you're leaving the room, heat your house 2 degrees less during the winter, don't turn on AC, use public transportation, you know, use less, turn on the off the faucet. It's a series of very, very simple tips, really, and people often aren't aware that it's a few simple gestures that make the biggest, are the biggest contribution.
And like what we saw in Paris, what was that, 2-3 weeks ago with the pollution problem and how they closed down the metros, or no, they let us use the metros for free, they would not close those down. Is that something that we have to be seeing in the future? Like, will that come up more often, or was that a once-off type of thing?
That will, I think that'll be coming more often, but that has nothing to do with climate change, though. That has to do with the fact that Paris is becoming a larger metropolitan area, and that happens occasionally when you have high-pressure systems. Am I getting technical? When it's pretty outside and the sun is out, then you have what's called a high-pressure system. So the air, instead of going up as it goes with a low-pressure system, comes down.
But I would say that in general, it's good to have policies in place to promote public transportation and to encourage people to use that more, because we know that the pollution generated by driving lots of vehicles when you don't need to does contribute to
absolutely
all of those problems.
Jane Goodall is going to be here next week. And do you know anything about how Jane Goodall has influenced the environment and how she has aided to the science world?
Well, I have a particular history with her in that I always wanted to work with animals, and from a very young age I idolized Jane Goodall because she, at a fairly young age herself, was sent out to Africa with no knowledge of the system, and was one of the first people to really describe in detail the behavior of these very elusive animals. That's her early work, and then since then I know she's been involved in a lot of conservation efforts, trying to bring a lot of the work that she was involved with early on to the public, and encourage people to help correct some of the really big problems.
The main motivation behind Jane Goodall's early research was the fact that this species was going extinct, that their habitat was being eroded. And one of the things many people aren't aware of is we are, de facto, in a major extinction event. Extinction events have happened all throughout the geological history, but we're living one right now. But that's one thing that she's been raising awareness about, is that we are in a major extinction event. You're talking about what effects do people have on the environment. Well, you know, loss of biodiversity is an enormous problem. Mm-hmm. It's happening on an unprecedented scale, and very few people are aware of this. And it's happening for many reasons. One of the reasons is loss of habitat, which is one of the things that Jane Goodall was motivated by. Mm-hmm. The area in which these primates live is getting smaller and smaller and smaller, encroached on by human society.
And this change that we're seeing with the environment and how the habitats of the primates are getting smaller and smaller, is that getting worse? Is that ever going to change and get better?
50 years.
I think part of the issue too is that, you know, you can, I would say that the sad stories outnumber the happy ones.
Yeah.
By far, and then there's also different perspectives. You can look at it as a single species success, where, you know, the cuckapoo is a good example, or the California condor, where they kind of fought back from the brink of extinction. But then there's also the real issue of, well, you know, are we in the, is it the job to save single species, or is it the job to save entire environments?
Okay, thank you so much for your time. And I hope that we all learned a lot about the environment today. And we're looking forward to having Jane Goodall at our university. Thank you.
Tuesday, May 20th at 7:30 at the Libre La Une in the CZM will be the Beckett Letters French translation launch. Volume 1 of the letters, co-edited by AUP Professor Dan Gunn and his student research team, will be recognized for their work, and the letters will be read at the event. Wednesday, May 21st is the last SGA Senate meeting of the semester. Meet at the Grand Salon at 12 noon, and as always, contact sgaaup.edu for more information.
I'm Gabriel Hennigan for AAP TV, and in less than a week from now, Jane Goodall is coming back to the university. We're all very excited about this, so I'm going to walk around campus right now and see what some people have to say about some of the issues that will be discussed at this event. So, the Jane Goodall event is coming up in almost a week. Are you going?
Yes, I am actually. I'm very excited.
You know, Jane Goodall is a big animal rights proponent. And one of the world's most famous vegetarians. Are you a vegetarian yourself?
No, but I was actually for a few years back in the day.
Fortunately, I'm not a vegetarian.
No.
No, I'm not a vegetarian.
Why are you not a vegetarian?
First of all, I like to eat meat.
I like chicken and I like turkeys.
How can you tell me a lion is supposed to eat a gazelle, but we're the most advanced form of evolution and we can't eat beef?
Why were you a vegetarian?
Because I felt I was too dependent on eating meat all the time and I wanted to eat more vegetables and become healthier, which I accomplished.
I would consider it.
Yeah, I have been for like a little bit, but like never for like over a few months.
So here we are, arguably the most intelligent beings that have ever walked planet Earth, and still we're destroying the only home we have. How do you feel about this quote?
Oh, I completely agree. We are slowly killing ourselves off. Just a matter of time.
It's really unfortunate, but true.
It's not that we don't care, it's just like when you think about it, the damage has been done real quick. We're just like actually starting to realize the potential of it right now, of like what it could do to us.
Usually I am optimistic, but not about this.
What do you think can be done to save the environment?
Even the most basic things, like just making sure you recycle and turn off the lights and like just really, really basic elements. And I think if each person can make a few changes in their lives, then on a grander scale it could help.
Be more aware of how they affect the planet, their consequences, actions.
Recycle.
Don't pollute. Be smart. Don't waste water.
Carpooling or like taking public transportation.
Basics.
It just like requires the cooperation of everyone in order for us to move forward.
Do you feel like you do enough yourself?
I definitely feel like I could do more. I do try.
Ever since living here, way more, because I live right around the corner from school, whereas I'm from Texas, and I would take a car 30 minutes every day to and from school. A
lot of gas.
Yeah.
Try to be a responsible citizen of the world and keep it clean. Do my share.
Good for you. There's no doubt our generation is facing challenging environmental issues. Hopefully Jane Goodall will be able to give us some insight into what these are and how to solve them when she comes to AAP on the 15th of May. If you haven't bought your tickets yet, please do, and we hope to see you at the event.
Spring 2014 graduation is Tuesday, May 27th to Wednesday, May 28th. The graduation gala will take place at Cercle de l'Union Interallié after the commencement ceremony. Reserve your gala tickets online, and for more information, contact senior class representative Philip Delahunty. There is a strict dress code for the event. All grades are due Wednesday, May 28th. Have a great summer, everyone. Good luck on your finals.
I am Juliette Moulin, and this is AUP TV.
I'm Ariel Delzer, and this is AUP TV.
I'm Jessica Benny, and this is AUP TV.
I'm Gabriel Hedengren, and this is AUP TV.
I'm Robin.
Nicholson, and this is AUPTV.